I can't explain to you how much fun this is. We do it night after night, and it gets better every single time.
We love you.
You guys are a landmark. Let me tell you, this is fantastic.
Love you.
We're gonna do some acoustic stuff for you. We love playing it, Mick and I. What am I looking for?
It's called a guitar. We used to sit around the campfire, so to speak, when you're filming a television show or a movie or anything. 90% of the time, you're just standing around waiting on the monkey's television show. I don't know, I figured we were only on camera maybe 2 hours a day out of a 10-hour day. Rest of the time is the crew and the direct, lighting and things and sound. So we had a lot of time on our hands, and we would sit around and play and noodle. And they built us this little room in the back of the set, a soundproof room, because it wouldn't bleed into the studio. And so we'd sit around and play. And of course, most of the time it would be a Nesmith tune, because he was the only one that had written anything. And this is one of the first ones I remember ever singing with you.
All right.
Well, eventually, I did write a song. And this is actually encouragement. I wasn't writing many tunes, and he came along and said, "Are you going to write some tunes for the albums?" I said, "Why?" He said, "Because that's where all the money is." I went to England with our first trip to England. Woo! We met the members of the royal family. No, not that royal family. The other ones. The Beatles. Yeah. I dropped that name on. And they threw us a party. And I'm told I had a great time. And I went back to my hotel and I wrote a song about my experience. And we went back to the States. Record company, and they say they want to release it in England as a single. And I said, "Cool." And they said, "But you have to change the name." I said, "What?" Said, "Yeah, the name you picked is rude." I said, "Wait a minute." I saw it on the BBC at like 7 o'clock at night. It was called Randy Scouse Skit. That's the name of the song. And I just saw on this TV show, one guy called the other guy a Randy Scouse kid, and I thought, "That's funny." I had no idea what it meant. I just, it was the 60s. Anyway, they said you have to have an alternate title. So the song was released under the name Alternate Title. And it went up to number 2 in the charts in the UK for many, many, many months. Only held out of the number 1 spot by that stinking group.